And we're back here on Badminton Europe TV live with the second semi-final. Second final. And today's Sunday, the Irish International. It's the women's singles final between Xiao Mai Pai from Chinese Taipei and the number 2 seed Carolina Marin from Spain. Sam is with me again after a quick tea break, Sam.
Yeah, very quick.
you get a break. Straight over the presentation, back to the interview, and back on the chair again.
I think that keeps you out of trouble, Mark.
Keeps me out of trouble, for sure.
Yeah.
Of course, we all know about Caroline and Marion. One of the up-and-coming talents from European badminton, world junior bronze medalist, and European junior champion, and of course winner here in Ireland 2 years ago at the tender age of 16, I think. Just turned 18 and just out of junior ranks and already pretty much a senior player.
She's going to be definitely one for the future.
Carolina.
On the world scene, I think. Even when you look at all the top ladies singles players, they're all quite old. You look at the Lalshi, Tina Bourne, Juliana Shank. It's great that we've got
Young Yan. All these players all coming to the end of their careers.
Yeah, maybe one after the Olympics. Some of them might decide to retire. And it's good you have someone like Carolina Marin taking up the European fight against these top class Asian players. It's fantastic.
Yeah, right on. No complaints from Carolina.
This is a great test for Carolina, though. Getting to play some Asian opposition.
Yeah, and she's reached this final with straight set wins in all her games. So far, beat Linda Tajiri.
That's quite.
In the semi-final, Linda injured towards the end of that semi-final. Left the court in tears. She walked by me in tears.
That was sad to see.
Mm-hmm. Xiao, of course, had a great win in the semi-final over top seed Pihong Yan, France.
Two.
earlier against another Spanish player, Beatriz Corrales. She took her to the 3 sets.
Oh, okay.
So, second Spanish match for the Chinese Taipei player.
Yeah, I think that could be crucial with the coach from Spain has already seen this player play and obviously knows the tactic.
And of course, just
very good play.
Of course, all the focus is on Marin in Spain, and she's the top player, but this girl, Corrales, is coming along behind her too, and is a really, really good player. I've seen her. Of course, Caroline beat her in the European Junior Final.
Yeah.
It was an all-Spanish final, so they're really spoiled for choice of women's singles.
But I think that's going to be crucial. Now the two of them keep appearing, practicing hard together, forcing each other to a higher level.
Yeah.
It's fantastic for Spanish bandit. I think Marin has really put Spain on the map as a bandit nation. Of course, we've had Pablo Abin for many years.
Yeah.
Thereabouts, but this is a really big talent pushing through now. It's good to see.
So professional.
Yeah.
Everything she does is professional. The way she conducts herself at tournaments, you rarely see her around except when she has to play her match.
Yeah, focused, really focused. Yeah. It's very focused in the warm-up because in the zone. very worthy cause.
Mm-hmm.
I become infamous on so many players, sure.
Mm-hmm. That Carolina will be a great ambassador.
Yes, for sure.
For Solibad, so happy birthday to Solibad.
And may there be many more.
Yeah.
Many happy returns. Just in case people at home don't know about Solibad, can you just explain a little bit about it?
Yeah, it's a charity foundation set up by my good friend in France. Everyone knows Raphael, the main man behind a lot of things in badminton, badminton photo, the bad scene,
bad style,
and through his involvement in badminton, set up Solibad, a charity foundation. Help underprivileged children all over the world.
Yeah.
Had that famous flash mob last year where everybody around the world in May of last year got together for a flash mob in different cities to raise lots and lots of cash.
That's the main thing for very worthy causes.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a fantastic idea if the players can give a little bit back.
Yeah. And there's been a huge involvement by all the badminton professionals, all wanting to get involved, so and Raphael works hard at it, dedicates all his time to it. This is the second birthday this week, so we look, as you said, Sam, we look forward to many more birthday celebrations for Solibad.
For sure. Maybe Kathy Moran's going to give Solibad a birthday win here.
Yeah, could be.
8-4. Playing well so far. Good deception. Just out of court there.
Service over.
overruled by the umpire. No real argument from Carolina.
I think the line judge is just a little bit slow to react.
She was originally going to cover her eyes, which was the right thing to do. Just instinctively give a call.
She calls us all over a lot of confusion. A lot of doubt.
Caroline has this great ability to just move on to the next point. Lovely shot. Oh, just out. Just out. Well left.
7-7-9-5. Yes.
Of course, Carolina at times been asked to tone down her vocals on court. I think she has a little bit, in some way, in some respect, she has control a little bit, but I love to see it. I think it's great.
Yeah, it's good to get some emotion. We know how the players are feeling.
Yeah.
But sometimes all good players.
What a shot.
Sometimes it can be a disadvantage to then our opponents can see how she feels if she's not shouting as well.
Shouting, she's winning, which is most of the time.
Yeah, that's true. But she definitely has one of these really strong attitudes. Quite similar to both her and Victor as well, Blacks and coach.
Yeah.
So determined.
6-10.
Yeah. She's got no fear of who she's playing either. Not overawed by the final against a very strong Asian player.
Very much in control, yeah. And again, just looking at her on face, interacting with her a little bit on Facebook over the last week or two, and she hasn't been feeling well. You can see her coughing a little bit and blowing her nose.
Yeah, I can understand.
I think it's the case with a lot of people around this week are sniffling. A lot of players.
It's quite cold, I think. Yeah. The weather here might be a little bit different than
in the Spanish. Yeah. Of course, not our normal coach coach here this week.
20 seconds. 20 seconds.
A Danish coach now living in Spain.
Mm-hmm.
Part of the Spanish setup.
Same corner, just out.
8-11.
I think this is a more free flowing game than we've seen Carolina on the score yesterday.
Yeah, for sure.
Eight.
So exquisite at the net.
actually has some really interesting service technique, because it's quite hard for girls to get that power on the back and serve the back line. You see a lot of
play. She rolls it in. And it's the same. It's the same motion for a short or a flick. So it's so confusing for the opponent. The roll, and then we don't know whether it's going to be a flick or a short.
Such a devastating flick as well. It's going so flat and fast.
But again, she's just developed that over this service motion. She always serves backhand. But it was much more predictable. You could see the flick coming. Now she's developed this roll with the body. And it's completely almost impossible to read whether it's going to be a flick or a short. It's exactly the same motion.
In that scene, in some way, nearly like a back and the way she goes back and pushes in. But for most people, keep it short, close motion. Like she's feeding herself a shuttle.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's very good, because I'm not sure if I'm maybe Tina Bond sometimes serves backhand. There's not many players do that in the ladies. For that very reason, that it's hard to get the flick on the back.
69. Yes.
It's pretty much one-way traffic now in this first game. 69 in... certainly. Caroline should go on and take this first game.
Yeah, I think she's looking very calm today.
Very calm. Such a marked difference between the game, this game, and the semi-final against Linda.
Having some talks with the coach, little small pep talks in between. Oh, well, that.
So much tension on the court yesterday. You could feel the tension between her and Linda.
I don't think either player really showed their best game yesterday, but the competitors today.
Service over.
still just looking extremely relaxed.
I think she knew that was a little wild herself. Maybe swung a little bit too much at her.
Ah, good play. From the Chinese Taipei girl.
With the Chinese Taipei starting to become a very strong nation in Bantamla. Got some great mix players, doubles players, lady singles as well as we've seen in the Worlds.
Yeah, exactly. And Pai, of course, will be full of confidence after the win over Pyongyang yesterday.
That's for sure.
Decision from Marin and really on top of her game.
19-12.
Pai just seems to be doing this job where she holds it on her forehand side, fakes the lift, and then plays across.
Yes.
I think it takes the tempo out of her play. And then Marin can really get around that, rather than take a backhand. Of course, her angles going across the left hand are they're deadly. So.
I love this service action. I really think it's efficient. It's effective. And so this deceptive.
Yeah, that's true. Really looks well today.
Mm-hmm.
In the arena.
Second game, Lovell play
was the second game, Lovell, as the umpire calls it, Marin, to serve.
The standard line on that one. He's in behind the corners.
One nil, and that's only the second time in the match that Pye has got her nose in front. Down the line.
It's fantastic. It's really fantastic.
Service over. 1-0.
Power mixed with accuracy is a deadly
failing to find the accuracy in that occasion, Carolina.
If you look at the high pace serve now, she just turns a shuttle just before she's about to strike it. Just and when I say that, she goes for the high
yeah.
Up into the roof it goes.
Service over. 2-0.
I think that's a good option.
Another pinpoint accuracy down the line again from Carolina.
3-2.
Yeah, for me, I think the tie paper should really try and play high to the back.
Yeah.
Make Carolina wait a little bit more, longer in the back. Get it on the back line. You gotta be really cool to do that and believe in your defense, so.
lethal again from Marin.
4-2.
Brilliant. Way too flat for the Taipei player.
Better.
Good run.
Seven silver.
outside of that, really.
5, 6.
You know, you've got the older brigade, Yao Yi and Pi Hong Yan. Yeah, and you have to look at Carolina and go, she's probably got the best chance of them all.
Yeah, that's true.
To do something.
The good thing about Carolina is she's young and she can always play above herself.
Yeah.
These older girls, they know what they have to do.
Carolina.
7-6-7.
Of course, that being said, the level that those other top Europeans are playing at is probably still one level higher than this.
Yes, of course. Yeah, sure.
Carolina keeps improving, keeps working hard. There's definitely no reason. Defense. Very well played.
Oh, yeah. Heavy cross court slice from Pi. Playing much better in the second game.
8-6.
Yeah, as a lead note, I think Carolina is just a little bit, her accuracy has gone down a little bit. She just needs to get the shuttle right in the corners again. I think those first couple of lifts at the start were wide, kind of through her column.
Yeah. But 3-point lead now for Pi. I knew she had the chance there.
Service over. 7-9. Service over.
11-8. Pi is getting into this game now, Sam.
That's for sure.
Certainly, the tide seems to have turned in favor of the Chinese Taipei girl. And she goes in 11-8. straight ahead. You could see the body language from the Chinese Taipei. At the end of that point, she's back in this game now. You know, I expected Carolina to go on and romp home in this second game, but it hasn't turned out that way. Yeah, because she just not the same as you said.
Yes, just a little bit off, and then when she misses one, she tries to bring the margin in a little bit. The pie's ready. It's a great shot.
Over 9, 12.
I think that's one thing if players are gonna play against Karina Moran, would like to be successful, you gotta be ready for that cross net from her forehand side. She reaches out, takes it early. She must be practicing a lot.
Good advertisement too for their kids sponsor.
Yeah.
Both players sponsored by the same brand.
That was well played.
Yeah, well played.
11-13.
Pulling ourselves back into this game now, just trailing by two. You were talking about again, Sam. That one was outside.
14-11.
I think we could have called that one for the Rangers. Quite unsighted on most of the lines, apart from this back line is ours.
This is our line, yeah. Oh, exquisite from Marin. Again, that heavy cross court. Net shot.
12-14.
Setting up the attack.
I think Moran is. She's not playing her best, but she's still 12-14, and that's the sign of a good player.
Hanging in there.
It's an easy game when you're playing well, but you're playing your best, and when you're winning and playing bad.
Yeah,
Carolina going for the almost impossible there. Breaking that wrist, the pull, the shuttle across court on the backhand side.
Service over. 13-16.
This is a great character. just has a smile. Maybe it's hurting inside them.
Out again.
Service of 17:30.
The angle on the sights just off from Carolina at the moment. Needs to find that accuracy again. Digging that shuttle level from the smash into the body.
Good rally, man. Moving each other around.
Shuttle's gone too, I think. Been wobbling through the air. Shuttle's definitely gone this time. Definitely gone. I thought it was gone the last time, but...
Oh, slightly boosted.
Yeah, right there. Good rally. Nice round of applause to the crowd.
14:19.
Just a moment, one feather breaks out like that. So all flies completely different to there. Cuts the wind speed. It's looking like 3 seconds mark. You're going to be too long. today's bomb than here.
Take this match.
great rally.
For an example. deciding conclusion.
Mark the last rally there just left us all asking, where was that temple all match?
Yeah, all of a sudden.
Both players just showed what they could do, and you could see that it was up. The temple was up, the speed of play was up. Not a clear, completely different game match for 1 point and 1 point only. But I think if both players come out like that on the third set, then we're really in for a treat here.
20 seconds.
Almost 3/4 of an hour already. 42 minutes on the game clock. Just turning to 43, so a pretty long match here.
Final game, Love All, play.
It's quite a tough to call the winner. We were, I think we were maybe overly confident on Carolina Marin.
One love.
Just keep your composure here. Test character. I don't think Caroline has played her best bundle in this week, and just shows the signs she's still in the final. In the final, and one set away from victory, so.
Oh. fight there from Carolina.
Maybe she's not expecting to play her best game here. I think Pai's just showing some experience here. The way she took on that point of 2019 just set the pace.
Something I think in Carolina's eye.
Maybe some games as well.
Could be. Just break the rhythm. Bit of a tempo. whole change here in Carolina, that's for sure.
It's big.
Yeah, that's what she needs to do now, I think. getting over the net. Poor execution. Separated by 5 spaces in the world ranking list. Carolina just off the first page of the world rankings to 26.
Short lift.
Steps over 4-10.
Pai has come straight here from the Macau Open last week. Got to the last 16. Really, when you look at the results, really nothing. Nothing to write home about. Get Chinese Taipei Open last year, of course.
It's a good result.
Last 16 in the French Open.
That's not a problem. You hit against it, bounce back. So it's your fault. 11-4. Interval. Change that.
That was really, I don't think we can ever see them like that. A Chinese Taipei player had played the shuttle back on the net and it was going out, and Carolina decided just to hit it to make sure. But she hit it and the girls put a racket up and I just came back and hit Carolina in the face. And the umpire. It was very quick to react, called the full straight away. But it was a very strange turn of events.
And it's not going your way, it's not going your way, it's just that's the way it's happening for the moment for Carolina.
It's a tough job here for the
events, of course, at the mid-game interval, this deciding set. Okay, this is a big few points now.
Yeah.
For the Spanish number one. Really need to do something now.
No, never mind.
Yeah. To avoid her opponent just getting out of sight.
Deception in that watch. she's held at Nancy. Still created the spin.
Carolina would just prefer 21 to come. fairly quick at this stage.
Yeah.
He just wants to get out of there now.
Probably knows that she's had her chance in this.
95.
Let's not take anything away from Pi. She's stuck in there. When
yeah. What a comeback. What a comeback after the first game.
Change some tactics. Work hard. Kept a smile and a good attitude the whole game. I think I'd say Caroline wants to smash down and play.
Five.
I wish she could play all day at this stage now. She can't miss.
Yeah, well played from the Chinese Taipei girl, Sam. I think really you have to applaud her for a comeback in this match. And Premazov